Hi, this is a challenge for Flat Earther. So here we have a globe. In reality, the Earth is not that round. It's a bit ovoid, but it's a bit simplified here. As you can see, we have dot B here. That is very big. And this is one point we have chosen on the globe. And as you can see, there is another big ball moving on the other side. It's the one which is furthest away, so it's the longest distance you can have on Earth. So you can pick any point. If you take the opposite one, it's the longest distance. Then you can see that there is another axis in red. You have one dot here, and the other one is there. So you can see, I can pivot to show it. And then you can see it's perpendicular, so that means that there is a 90 degree angle. And now you can also see that there is this green arcs that I can turn around. What is it showing? It's the shortest path from this point to that point. So as you saw, I took the perpendicular to the first longest path I chose. And you can see that I have an infinite amount of paths to go from that point to that point. It's the same to go from that point to that point. We will have another arc here, and we could rotate it around, and all paths would be of the same length. So that's how it works on Earth, on global Earth. And you can see also that because this point is the furthest away to that point, there is no shorter distance, because by definition they are the furthest away. Same for these two, which are perpendicular. You can see that there is no shorter distance than the one we found. So that's for the 3D Earth. So now let's go to the 2D Earth. This is a 2D flat Earth. I didn't choose a circle because the circle makes things obvious. And there is it's not interesting as a case, since the longest path is a diameter. So voilà, there is only, it's like in the sphere I show, it's very boring. So let's take a case where it may have some difference that may help to prove that there is more than one path and stuff like that. So we have two points A and B. Here we have the point A, here we have the point B. I can move them freely. And you can see that as for the globe, we have a perpendicular line with 90 degree angles, which shows the other path length. If we move this one to take the greatest path, and for that I have made a small tools made of circles. If we take the longest path, this one can only be as long as the longest path, the same as in the globe. If the blue line was the longest path, the red line could only be of the same length or smaller. So I will use my tool. So what it does is simply give a radius. And I can see, okay, from there to there, you see I can take this point and put it here because it would be further away. So let's go. And now I can increase this, and I will find that I can put this that one there. So we have one of the longest distance. Let's check if I do that. The circle is not getting it, so it's okay. But the circle is getting closer. So this one is longest distance. And I can iterate like this to find the exact longest distance, but that's not very important. What is important is that we are close to it. And here you have A and B, and I can tell that there is no shortest path from A to B than what I have chosen. And voilà. Here we can also see that there is only one way to go from A to B, In the globe, there was many an infinite of way to do that, and for the perpendicular path, the same holds. So E and D are the shortest distance between these two points, and there is only one way to do it. So the challenge is to find a way such that there is more than one way from A to B and E to D, as it is in reality. Also, if you take the two shortest paths, the distance should not be, you shouldn't find a path which has a shortest distance. In the case of the globe, if you took two points that were close, there is two ways to go from one to, for example, to go from there to there. You can take the short distance, or you can take the full distance, or any other path that will be longer than the shortest path. Here, it's not possible, but some say that it is, because they say that it matches the reality, and in the reality, if you have one path, you can usually take another one, which will be a straight path and lead you back to the start. So it's broken with this flat earth. So maybe I'm missing something, and people are open to explain how it happens that you have many ways from one point to another point, and that if you take the biggest distance on earth, flat earth, then there is a shorter distance that appears. So it's something to explain, and also this warping that happens on the sides. So if you are on the North Pole, why you teleport 1,000 kilometers by making few steps? So that's something that is very odd. We can take a circle, which is even easier to show that it's very inconsistent. But I wanted to show this map with a small tool because it's geometrically more interesting. But all I said holds for a circle, and it's even simpler. So voilà. Good luck showing this, and enjoy doing it.